Let's talk about Grok 3. 2 weeks ago, we looked at DeepSeek because it was the hot topic. Today, it's Grok 3. Tomorrow, it will be something else. The AI world moves fast, and every new model promises to change everything. But does it really? Let's get back to Grok 3. And yes, it's another large language model, just like ChatGPT and DeepSeek. Nothing groundbreaking there. But what makes Grok 3 different isn't just the technology, it's who's behind it. And you already know who I'm talking about, Elon Musk. Now, why is Elon Musk suddenly building his own LLM? To understand that, we first need to go back and look at his complicated history with OpenAI. Year was 2015. At the time, AI was advancing fast, and Musk, along with other tech leaders, believed that it needed to be developed responsibly. So he teamed up with Sam Altman and a group of researchers to create OpenAI, an organization that would keep AI open source, ethical, and accessible to everyone. They believed that no single company should control artificial intelligence. And Musk wasn't just offering his opinions. He was one of OpenAI's biggest funders, pouring in millions of dollars to get things started. But then things changed. As OpenAI grew, it shifted from a non-profit research lab into a for-profit company. The same company that once promised to keep AI open now started developing closed-sourced commercial AI models like GPT-3 and GPT-4. And Musk wasn't happy. He argued that OpenAI had become exactly what it was created to prevent: a corporate-controlled AI powerhouse. And in 2018, he cut ties with the company completely. Since then, Musk has been one of OpenAI's biggest critics, calling it out for abandoning its original mission and accusing it of being too closely tied to Microsoft. After his criticisms, Elon Musk didn't just stop there. As the richest person on Earth, he didn't just cry in a corner. Well, okay, maybe he did that. But he also started pouring money into something else. He founded a company called XAI and started developing large language models called Grok. And since it's Elon Musk, nothing is straightforward. Unlike other LLMs, which train on massive datasets of books and articles, he decided to train his model, Grok, heavily on Twitter data. And that's where the controversy starts. Anyone who has spent little time on Twitter can see how extremely biased and misinformative it can be. But for Musk, unsurprisingly, this controversial point is both his bet and his selling point. He believes that real-time data from social media will help Grok surpass traditional LLMs. Whether that works or just turns Grok into a really smart Twitter troll is something we will find out soon enough. Also, if it seems like every major tech company now has its own AI model, you're not wrong. OpenAI offers ChatGPT. Google has Gemini. Meta developed Llama. Anthropic presents Claude. And Elon Musk's XAI introduced Grok. But why? Isn't it too much? Why is there an AI arm race happening right now? Well, companies like Google, Meta, and Twitter aren't just training AI models for fun. They are doing it because they already own massive amounts of user data, and they want to use that to their advantage. Think about it. Google is training its AI using search data, YouTube transcripts, and Gmail interactions. Their LLM doesn't just generate text. It knows what people are searching and watching for every single day. And Meta, who owns Facebook, Instagram, and WhatsApp, has access to billions of conversations across its platforms. They're using that to make AI-powered chat and content creation tools. Also, as we discussed, Elon Musk is using Twitter data to make Grok more real-time and tuned into what's happening in the world. In short, these companies aren't starting from scratch. They're taking the massive amounts of data they already have and turning it into AI models that leverage their existing platforms. If OpenAI is the generalist in this race, these companies are trying to make specialized AIs that deeply integrate into their ecosystems. In conclusion, I know it is hard to keep up with all these LLMs, and unfortunately, this trend will continue in the future. To avoid boring you to death with numbers again, I've chosen to not include a graph this time. However, recent benchmarks indicate that the leading LLMs are performing quite similarly. In future videos, we will explore the reasons behind this and discuss whether models are genuinely improving or just becoming better at benchmarks. So stay tuned. We have many topics to discuss. Thank you guys for watching. I know that you forgot to like and subscribe, but I'll see you in another video.